Orot Abil, 86 years old, is nursing injuries at Lira Regional Referral Hospital. He said he was attacked on June 16th by two people who broke into his house and poured acid on his face. I don't know why they would want to kill me, but I imagine it's a land conflict. That fateful night, I was woken up by movements, and when I opened the door to take a close look, I saw people trying to push through my door. When I opened to take a close look, the suspects poured a liquid on my face that I anticipated was hot water because I could feel my face burn. And then Madam Alam and my family members took me to the police and later to the health center. However, I was referred to Lira Regional Referral Hospital the next morning. I am currently here in hospital nursing wounds, but I don't owe anyone anything. The victim alleges that the suspects, who are currently on the run, are Jonathan Okero and Jimmy Ogwang. He says he has two grandchildren, Stephen Okot, 6 years old, and James Ariel, 4 years old, who are injured and are getting treatment at Arum Health Center. When we got a report that my father was attacked, he responded to find he was being taken to the hospital. I'm currently taking care of him. My sister, Apio Sylvia, was also attacked. We have some land conflicts, and I believe this might be the reason for the attacks. Leonard Opio Ojok, the LC5 chairperson of Agago, confirmed the report, saying police are currently handling the matter.
I'm aware. He called me. I was in Kulu. I told the DPC to link up with the clan because that is not like a social matter. That is a criminal matter. The police must investigate and arrest these people for attempted murder.
Meanwhile, two children identified as Ismail Oguli, 7 years old, and Iwiru, 5 years old, were burnt beyond recognition yesterday night in Otage village of Kaberamaido district. The two children, aged 7 and 5, were burnt when their parents were not at home. The OC of Kaberamaido Police Station, Rita Nantaba, said investigations are underway, but the father of the children, Sheriff Oyuji, has already been detained.
You give us time, we take the bodies for post-mortem. They are going to check the bodies, then we shall bring them back.
The LC1 of Otage Village, Musa Ekaju, says the family has been having marital affairs and the biological mother of the children had left the home. Meanwhile, Bena Ibeta, who was among the first responders, says she called out the children's stepmother from the neighborhood, but the house was already ablaze. By the time the father of the children got to the scene of the situation, it was already out of hand. Leaders were saddened by the unfortunate incident that left many people traumatized. Police had to whisk Oyugu, the father of the deceased, away from the angry residents who blamed him for having left the children locked in the house. Report by Hudson Punyu and Michael Onyinge for the news.